Hey guys, so it's about 6:30 and I'm already ready, so that's good. And we're going to see the Prime Meridian and Shakespeare's House, Cotswold, Whirl, or whatever it's called, and Bath. Yeah, we're going on like a bus tour thingy, so that'll be fun to get some good pictures and a fun vlog, I think.
And monarchs to behold the swelling sea. Then, should the warlike Harry, like himself, assume the port of Mar. And at his heels, leashed in like hound, should famine, sword, and fire crouch for employment. But, pardon, gentles all, the flat and raised spirits that have dared on this unworthy scaffold to bring forth so great an object. Can this cockpit hold the vasty fields of France? Or may we cram within this wooden O the very casks that did affright the air at Agincourt? Oh, hark! Since a crooked figure may attest in little place in millions, and let us, sightless to this great account, on your imaginary forces work. Suppose within the girdle of these walls are now confined two mighty monarchies, whose hard, upreared, and abutting fronts the perilous narrow ocean parts asunder. Piece out our imperfections with your force, into a thousand parts divide one man and make imaginary puissance. Think, when we talk of horses that you see, printing their proud hooves in the receding earth, for 'tis your thoughts that now must deck our king, carry them here and there, jumping o'er times, turning the accomplishment of many years into an hour. For which supply, admit me, chorus to this history, who prologue like your humble patrons pray, gently to hear, kindly to judge, our play.
To give a bit of a variety, I thought I'd do a song. We also do scenes, songs, sonnets, you name it, we do it. So this is a song from A Midsummer Night's Dream. It's called Titania's Lullaby. It's the song the fairies sing to lull Titania to sleep. So the words are by Shakespeare. The music, inevitably over the years, changes somewhat, but the words are there. So here we are.
You spotted snakes with double tongue, thorny hedgehogs be not seen. Crimson blind worms do no wrong, come not near our fairy queen. Singing our sweet lullaby, la la lullaby, loo la lullaby. Never harm us, found no charm, come a lovely lady nigh, loo la la lullaby, loo la lullaby. Weaving spiders come not here, hence your long legs spinners, hence. Beetles black approach not near, worm nor snail do no offence. Fill a melody, singing our sweet lullaby, la la lullaby, la lullaby. Never harm or spell or charm, come a lovely lady nigh, la la lullaby, la lullaby, la lullaby.
that was totally part of the house back then.
Mm-hmm.
It was like, that's original. It's been here the whole entire time. Original part of the house.
Scratching would not make it worse if it were a face as yours, sir. Well, you are a rare part of teacher.
A bird of my kind, but a beast of yours.
I wouldn't have my hawk at the speed of your tongue. I'm so good at it.
What do I need? Oh my gosh. So much Doctor Who. This is great.
words to describe how much I hate this song. It's like the worst song ever.
Oh, what is that about?
Hey guys, so I'm actually using my big camera right now because my smaller camera stopped letting me record things, so I've been recording on my bigger camera now, and it's kind of heavy. I'm just gonna set it down there. Okay, basically what happened was when we were in Shakespeare's birthplace, we found out that we had a flat tire. And so what happened then was that we got stuck there for 3 hours, and then they finally got the tire changed. So at 3 o'clock we left, and we had decided to just skip Bath, which is where they had like ancient Roman baths, and I really didn't care about that anyway, so I was like, yeah, skip it. So then we drove all the way to Stonehenge, and we got there at around 5:30 maybe? But yeah, so basically then at 7 we left Stonehenge and then drove back, or started driving back. But the thing is that the bus drivers at these companies can only drive for a certain amount of hours, and so at 9:30 we were about maybe 5 minutes away from a tube station, which was good, but the bus driver had exceeded his limit. But the thing was that we were almost to a tube station where he could have let us off. So we had to then, we were then going to have to wait for another driver to come and get us. But instead, my mom, my dad, and I, and some other people, got off the bus to then go walk to a nearby tube station. And now it is about 10:45, and we got home maybe 15 minutes ago. And yeah, so basically we've just had a crazy day, and I'm really tired, and I just want to go to sleep. So I will see you guys tomorrow with another day of edge. Bye!